As you learned, when we're under the gun of the fight-or-flight nervous system and the brain and body are knocked out of homeostasis because of stress, the different compartments of the brain begin to fire incoherently and send a very incoherent message down the spinal cord to each individual little brains that are under the control of the autonomic nervous system. And all of a sudden, these individual brains begin to fire incoherently. And they begin to send an incoherent message to the associated organs and tissues in different parts of the body. Now think about this. When this brain becomes incoherent, we practice opening our focus or opening our awareness, and the act of doing that starts to create more order in the brain. So what if you were to rest your attention in each one of these energy centers, and where you place your attention is where you place your energy. The more you keep your attention on it, the more you're giving it your life force or energy. And as you rest your attention in each one of these centers, and you can become aware of the space around these centers, like individual beach balls of energy, and you move from your first center to your second center, behind your navel and slightly below it, and that was your target, and you tuned in to its energy, and then your third center, in the pit of your gut, resting your attention in that center and becoming aware of the space around it. As you learned in your heart and the space around your heart, in your throat, anchoring your attention in your throat and becoming aware of the space around it, connecting to your pineal gland, sensing the space it occupies in space and tuning into its energy and its frequency, resting your attention in the center of your head where your pituitary gland is and becoming aware of the space around your head. Just like creating coherence in your brain, you would begin to create coherence in each one of these individual energy centers. And when these individual brains become more coherent, they begin to send a very coherent message to all the cells and tissues and organs of the body. So we can understand then that so many people heal themselves of so many different health conditions because they understood what they were doing and why. It has taken some time for people to practice both convergent and divergent focus. It takes some time for people to learn how to regulate and slow their brain waves down so they can begin to reprogram their autonomic nervous system. So all of the training that we've done up until this point is to begin to practice creating coherence in each one of these individual energy centers. And as I said, we've seen people heal from rectal cancer, prostate cancer, enlarged prostate, impotence. We've seen them heal from uterine fibroids, uterine tumors, ovarian cysts, diverticulitis, indigestion, acid reflux, high liver enzymes, heart palpitations, arrhythmias, heart disease, thyroid conditions, thyroid tumors, brain tumors, depression, anxiety. All different health conditions once we learn how to create coherence in each one of these individual energy centers. Now, the beauty behind it is that you don't have to spend a whole lot of time doing it once you know how to do it. And we begin to ascend our energy and we begin to create balance in each individual energy center. Let's talk about the word called ligand or ligar, meaning to bond. There are three types of ligands that you have in your brain and body. The first type is called neurotransmitters. And neurotransmitters communicate chemically between neurons. They are chemical messengers that send different messages in the nervous system. The second type of ligand is called neuropeptides. And neuropeptides are chemical messengers that begin to signal hormonal centers. So then once a neuropeptide is released from the limbic brain, has a very specific target, and that target goes to the individual hormonal centers, the ligand then begins to activate the hormonal system, and we begin to release certain chemicals. So then, if a person is thinking certain thoughts, like they're suffering, or they're in pain, or they feel guilty, they'll begin to activate different neurological networks in their brain that are connected to different experiences of the past. The moment they begin to turn on enough neurological networks, all of a sudden, neuropeptides are created, and now we begin to signal different hormonal centers for us to begin to feel exactly the way we were just thinking. So now that neuropeptide makes its way to the second energy center in the body, and the person starts to feel bad, or the person starts to feel guilty, or the person starts to suffer, or the person starts to feel unworthy. Now they're feeling exactly the way they were just thinking. And the moment you start to feel those feelings, of course, the brain checks in with the body and generates more corresponding thoughts equal to the way you were feeling. So now over time then, we keep taking energy and storing it in these lower energy centers of the body. And now the job is to begin to create balance and equilibrium in each one of these energy centers. So, take a look at the first three energy centers of the body. The first three energy centers of the body are energy consumers. In other words, when you begin to feel certain emotions that are related to the first three energy centers, we're drawing from the field and we're using energy to make chemistry. When we start getting to our fourth energy center, this center and above begins to release energy or cause energy to move out. So then, when we bless the energy centers of the body, when we rest our attention in each one of these energy centers, and you tune in to its frequency or energy, I want you to rest your attention in these centers, and I don't want you to feel them with your head. I want you to feel them with each one of those energy centers. For example, if I asked you to rest your attention in your fifth center, and I asked you to tune into its frequency, I would want your mind to be in your throat and tune into the energy of that center. When you tune into those energy centers and I ask you to tune in and receive, you're going to be drawing from that field and creating coherence in each one of those individual brains. Coherence is order, it's health. Incoherence is disease or a lack of balance. And if you can put a coherent signature over an incoherent energy, coherence will begin to entrain incoherence. And when that happens properly, all of a sudden now, when there's total coherence, we would call that a healing. So then the formula for doing this is putting your attention in your first center, becoming aware of the space around it, tuning into its energy and receiving. Then moving your attention to your second center, finding it, feeling it, paying attention to it, staying present with it, and tuning into its energy and its frequency. And the longer you're conscious of this energy, the more you're drawing from that field and creating coherence in that center. Then you put your attention in your third center, in the pit of your gut, and tune into its energy, and tune and receive its frequency, and so on to the fourth, the fifth, the sixth, the seventh, and finally to the eighth. And when we get to the eighth, all I want you to do is become aware that you're up in this space up here. Tune in to its energy, and the emotion that I want you to feel is gratitude when you do it. Because gratitude represents receiving. And all I want you to do is feel worthy to receive. And then you'll go to this invisible field around your body, that field called the true self, tuning in to your own energy. Now let's back up here with a little bit of physics. When atoms come together and they bond, they begin to exchange energy. And when you exchange energy, you exchange information. Now you can't see that individual field. You can't see the field around the atoms, but it's that energy that's holding the atoms together. Once those atoms form a molecule, they begin to behave differently. They have a different boiling point. They have a different specific gravity. They have a different weight. All of a sudden, the atoms coming together to form a molecule take on different characteristics. And if you keep adding more and more atoms, you'll begin to form a chemical. And there's an invisible field of energy and information that's holding that chemical together. If you take enough chemicals and you assemble them into order, you can create a cell. And now the cell has its own individual energy, its own light and information that's literally instructing the cell. And in the latest research in information biology says that it's not charged molecules randomly instructing the cell, but it's the cell's light and energy that's allowing the cell to have its instructions. The more coherent that light is, the better the cell functions.